In this tutorial, I showcase how to work on the overfitting issue by resizing the dataset at each training iteration. Overfitting is an issue that appears when training a model for a prolonged period of time on the same dataset. When computing the loss on the dataset that we use for training, we might see it decrease consistently over time, but when testing another dataset, we might see the model performance decrease greatly after crossing a certain point. By training the model on a unique dataset, we overfit the learnable parameter to this specific dataset and fail to establish a model that is able to tackle a generalization of the task at hand. If we generate the dataset in Houdini, like I did in my previous tutorial, we actually have the opportunity to tweak a couple of parameters and use a completely unique dataset at each training iteration. I will start with a quick Python demonstration on how you can inside one Python script node recook multiple times any node in Houdini and reload the geodata. I will start with a point and a point wrangle. Inside the point wrangle, I will define a for loop that will add points, and the stop condition of that for loop will be a parameter. So by changing that parameter, we change the number of points. I will finish my node tree with a null and a Python script node that will display the current number of points. We can access the parameter that controls the number of points from inside the Python script node. But you can see that even if we access it multiple times and each time we re-import the number of points, the number of points doesn't change. The number of points only change as we execute the Python script again, and the parameter has been tweaked by the previous execution. Instead of fetching the geometry from the Python script node, we can fetch it from the null node. And this way, we can trigger multiple recook as we tweak the parameter and fetch the data. This is a good way to compute multiple datasets while executing only one Python script node. Because keeping track of all the parameters we want to tweak is tedious, we can instead randomize the dataset depending on the frame number and load a different frame each time we want a new dataset. I will link the frame number with our parameter, and inside the Python script node, I will set the current frame using u.setFrame. This will come with a couple of issues. One will be that our Python script node is now time dependent, so it will attempt to recook at every frame. It also makes the timeline harder to scroll, as the frame number is set back by the Python script node. We can capture and reset the frame number at the beginning and end of the code, but this only works if there is no error. To solve that issue, we will come up with our own Python script node. I put down a null node and add two parameters, a string and a button. The string will be a multi-line and in Python, it will be the code that we want to execute, and the button will trigger the execution of the code. This will solve our time dependency issues, but now any error will trigger a pop-up and the timeline is still jumping back. One solution is to actually execute another code with a button that we will call safety. This code will handle capturing and resetting the frame number, and we will print any error that we have to the shell. Now we can replace the Python script node of the previous tutorial with this new node, and work on randomizing and reloading the dataset at every frame. I link the seed of the ptnum to the frame number, and I also make sure that the noise that we apply to our dataset depends on time. I copy-paste my code into my new node, and I will just change a couple of things. To make it more simple, I will just use the input answer to capture the trace, so we don't need the save input anymore. I also want to rework the part where I import the dataset. I want to do this at every iteration, so we define a function that will do that for us. The only issue being that the input and target answer are being created inside the definition, so they need to be defined as global in order to use them from the outside. The training will be now a two-step process. First, I want to reseed, I want to fetch a new dataset, and use that new dataset to train our model. To make sure that everything is working, I will just print the first tensor of the dataset, and you can see that at every iteration, this tensor is changing. After running the training a couple of times, I get an iteration that I like. I am not trying to reach a lower loss than the previous tutorial, because it is acceptable to reach higher loss on a dataset that is less repetitive. To check that everything is working, I will load the model like we did in our previous tutorial. Here, we don't want to change the Python script node because we do want a new prediction at every frame.